Breaking news coming in related to that. It's not only Sushant Singh Rajput's case, but Mumbai police compromised on the probe in the death of his ex-manager Disha Salian as well, as the facts are emerging. Times Now has access to Disha's autopsy report, which clearly states that the autopsy was conducted 2 days after her death. The cops displayed no urgency in the probe despite an unnatural death claim made in the report. Arunil is with me for more inputs on the story. Arunil, this is, at best we can define this as shoddy probe, and lack of urgency on the part of Mumbai police is glaring. In a suicide case, why would you not conduct autopsy immediately when you get to know about the case, as is the protocol?
Well, experts in fact mention about it that immediately a postmortem and forensic needs to be conducted, even if the police suspect that it is a suicide. But in this case, completely callousness from the Malbhani police station. Basically, the Mumbai police doing the postmortem after 2 days. In fact, he died on 9th, and on 11th, postmortem and the forensic was done by the Mumbai police. So that really raises question: why so much of delay, and whether there is any foul play in this? That is some question that some of the people from the BJP are asking. BJP leader and Rajya Sabha MP Narayan Rane also raised question with that, with respect to whether there was any link between the Disha Salian case and the actor Sushant Singh Rajput case. When we spoke to these police officers from Malbhani police station, they clearly maintain that there is no link at all, and they have been maintaining that it was a suicide only, and there is no link between these two cases. And yesterday also we saw how a press note was issued by the Malbhani police station asking people to come forward and give out any evidences or any information if they had related to the Disha Salian case. So after around 50 days, 2 months, asking people for evidences, that really speaks volume of what kind of probe the Mumbai police is conducting, or whether any investigation on that front was conducted at all. On the Sushant Singh Rajput case, if you look at it, since the start...
Hold on that point just a bit. And I'm also going to quickly go across to a news editor, Bhavtosh, who is with me on the broadcast. Bhavtosh, let's stick with the facts that are emerging of Disha Salian's case. When you get the information related to an unnatural death, was it not incumbent on Mumbai police to really immediately call for an autopsy and then determine the facts as to what led to her death?
Well, as far as the procedure goes, within 72 hours, the body has to be identified by close relatives or family members. Disha family lived in Mumbai. Obviously, they would have been informed. Then why this delay of 24 to 48 hours, why the postmortem was not conducted immediately? And now, adding to what Arneel has said, reports are emerging that the postmortem was not even videographed, no forensic examination of the crime scene was done. And more importantly, there was no recreation of the accidental death, if we call it an accidental death, by using a dummy of the same size and same weight as that of Disha Salian. Now, all this raises suspicion, and the very fact, as Arunil rightly said, that after 50 days, the Malbhani police station issued a statement asking people to provide information, clues about the case, speaks volume about the professional manner in which they have carried out the investigation. This raises a very specific question as to is Mumbai police trying to bury the truth? Are they hiding something? Because their behavior has been very suspicious. When you look at this case now, instead of asking for information, they should have carried out a proper professional probe as far as Disha's death is concerned.
Okay, Arunil, the glaring lapses on Mumbai police's part are there for everyone to notice, not just in Disha Salian's case, but also pretty much in Sushant Singh Rajput's case. And the point that Bhavtosh was raising, that these are some very valid questions as to, was some information not shared with public that Mumbai police came across? What is it that they are trying to hide? Because clearly there is much more information with them than what they have put out.
Well, that is right. I mean, who all were present when Disha Salian committed suicide? Who all were present in the alleged party before that as well in Malad region? That's what was reported as well. Whether the phone details network details of all the people in the vicinity was taken. All these questions have been asked by the opposition mainly, and the most important question is there any link between the Disha Salian case and actor Sushant Singh Rajput's suicide, because it happened within a span of around a week only. So the Mumbai police is clearly maintaining that there is no link at all. They also asked people to come forward with evidences or any information. But yes, glaring lapses in both the cases as well. If you look at actor Sushant Singh Rajput's case as well, in February itself, the family had alerted the Mumbai police about something wrong with the people who were close to actor Sushant Singh Rajput. But yet, Riya Chakrabarty was never questioned by the Mumbai police. They were only interrogating top Bollywood producers or directors. So why not Riya Chakrabarty questioned on that? And the financial details also, how close to actor Sushant Singh Rajput, who were removed in a span of 3 months when Riya Chakrabarty entered into the picture. They all have been saying that they were removed, they were sacked on the insistence of Riya Chakrabarty. That is also raises many eyebrows, but why didn't it create alarm bells in the minds of Mumbai police officers as well?
Okay.
That is the main question.
Just hold on for a bit. In fact, these are some examples of the shoddy probe conducted by Mumbai police in connection not just with Sushant Singh Rajput's death case, but also of his former manager Disha Salian, who curiously committed suicide just a week before the actor died. Now, we were getting a reaction of the Bihar DGP. I believe we'll play that out in just a bit. But Bhavtosh, you know, now if you join the dots in an investigation, okay, I think we'll just quickly play out that reaction of Bihar DGP and then I'll take up questions with our reporters.
सर्वोच्च न्यायालय में भी माननीय सर्वोच्च न्यायालय ने सुनवाई के दौरान कुल टिप्पणी की कि ये गलत है, किसी आईपीएस अफसर को क्वारंटीन किए हुए हैं, अनप्रोफेशनल तरीका है ये। उसके बाद पटना के आईजी ने वहाँ के अधिकारी से बात की, तब तो माननीय सुप्रीम कोर्ट का ऑब्जर्वेशन आ गया। अब आप क्या कहना है, फिर भी कोई सकारात्मक जवाब नहीं दिया। मुझे उम्मीद थी कि शाम तक या रात तक उसको छोड़ देंगे, लेकिन रात में कहीं 11 बजे के आसपास मैंने जब बात किया अपने पदाधिकारी से, तो उसने बताया कि उन्हें अभी मुक्त नहीं किया गया है और उसी तरह घर में जैसे थे उसी तरह गेस्ट हाउस में हैं। वो डर से बाहर टहलने भी नहीं निकल रहे हैं कि उनके खिलाफ मुकदमा न दर्ज कर लें।
तो सर, वो जो बाकी 4 लोग हैं, अगर क्वारंटाइन का नियम उनका सही है, तो उन बाकी 4 लोग को भी तो करना चाहिए, लेकिन वो बोल रहे हैं कि नहीं करेंगे हम उनको।
ये तो मैं कई बार बोल चुका हूँ,
कोर्ट जाएगी बिहार सरकार।
हम लोग देख रहे हैं, तय कर रहे हैं, राय ले रहे हैं, अधिवक्ता महाधिवक्ता से बात करेंगे, उसके बाद आइए कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन डिसाइड करेंगे।
आपका एक लंबा इतिहास रहा है बिहार पुलिस में, लेकिन इस तरह का बिहेवियर आपने कहीं देखा किसी पुलिस का, किसी भी दूसरे स्टेट के पुलिस?
मैंने लगता है पूरा देश ने नहीं देखा होगा, मेरी क्या बात है।
तब तो ये होगा सर कि वहाँ की पुलिस भी यहाँ आएगी, तो आप लोग कड़ा रुख अपनाइएगा।
हम ऐसे थोड़े ही करेंगे, हम ऐसे नहीं कर सकते।
उनको गुप्तेश्वर पांडे से लगता है कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, जिस तरह से आपने अपनी बात रखी है।
मैं सच बोलता हूँ, अगर इससे किसी को प्रॉब्लम है तो उसमें क्या दिक्कत है, हमारा क्या दोष है? हम आपको चिट्ठी लिख करके अपने अफसर को भेज रहे हैं आपकी जानकारी में, तो आपको बोलना चाहिए। मैंने वहाँ के DGP को SMS दिया है कि सिर्फ 3 दिन के लिए जा रहा है। DGP साहब अपने मोबाइल में SMS देखे नहीं है? 3 दिन के लिए कोई जाएगा, क्वारंटीन कर लीजिएगा।
Bhavtosh, we got another scathing reaction really from the Bihar DGP, and I wanted to ask you that, you know, in a normal sequence of events, when someone has perhaps taken the extreme step of taking his own life, and there is a case of a similar incident just a week before of someone who was close to the person, why would Mumbai police take so long to dig into the details and join the dots of these two cases coming so close to each other?
Well, that's the question that Mumbai police needs to answer as to why they were so unprofessional when it came to investigating Disha Salian's case. Several lapses can be found. The clothes that she was wearing were not forensically examined. The phone was sent for forensic examination. 4 days after the postmortem was conducted to retrieve the data. More importantly, only 2 samples have been sent, one to rule out the possibility of any kind of sexual assault, and second was for whether there was some kind of intoxication or drugs that she might have taken. Apart from that, the forensic team never visited the crime scene. Now, why the forensic team never visited the crime scene is a question that both Maharashtra government as well as Mumbai Police Commissioner needs to answer, because that's the basic in any criminal investigation. You have to send a forensic crime team to carry out its own examination of that particular spot, whether it was a case of accidental death, whether she committed suicide, or to rule out the third possibility of murder. Her friend's statements have not been taken. There was definitely a delay. And the very fact that the family has left the residence, that is also very mysterious. Why will the family leave the residence when Bihar police was present there? Is someone putting pressure on them? Because yesterday they issued a statement virtually blaming the media. Is it because Mumbai police is exerting pressure on them? And there is this hurried approach on the part of Mumbai police to somehow just close the investigation in Disha Salian case. And the very fact that that her death was followed by Sushant Singh Rajput death raises many questions needs to be answered.
That's right. And Arunil, what are we picking up from the family of Disha Salian? Are they, just like Sushant's family, not satisfied with the way Mumbai police really, investigated the circumstances that led to her death?
Well, the family of Disha Salian spoke to Times Now. They spoke to Siddhant Mishra from Times Now, and they clearly maintain that they are not sure whether it was a suicide or an accidental death. And that clearly shows that appropriate information or communication hasn't happened from the Mumbai police side with the family. But they are not as vocal as actor Sushant Singh's family. But then why Mumbai police is repeatedly being saying that it is mere coincidence? In fact, since the day actor Sushant Singh Rajput committed suicide, Times Now has been speaking to these investigation officers of Disha Salian's case as well. They have always been maintaining that it is only a mere case of suicide and there is no link. It is just a coincidence. But then why there are lapses with respect to the investigation that the Malwani police was conducting, as Bhautosh was pointing out to the main points with respect to the investigation that usually has to be done. Those were not done in the Disha Salian case. And is there a cover-up? And if at all there is a cover-up, then on whose insistence there is a cover-up in this entire case? That is the big question that arises, because whatever the Bihar police also wanted to do in the city of Mumbai, why there were blockades created? Firstly, you don't want to investigate. There are lapses in your investigation. And when somebody reaches your city and wants to investigate further, you create roadblocks. That raises some major eyebrows.
All right. Thanks very much, Arunil and Bhautosh, for joining us with your inputs on the story. And we will, of course, continue to update our viewers with the latest on this. But at the moment, we have to take a very quick break here. We'll be back on Morning News Hour in just a bit.